So I'll take 1 minute to talk about the DNA building in our company. So some examples. So in the kitchen staff, we have 5% attrition year on year, which compared to industry average is about 120%. The CDO level, which is each kitchen is managed by a guy who is called a chief delight officer. He is the real CEO of the business. I am not. And that guy owns the P&L, customer delight, everything. It's his business. He drives it. In the last year, out of the 190 CDOs, we lost one CDO. That's the level of attachment, that's the level of vision alignment we have in our company. In the XCOM, which is senior management, me and seven other people, all of these guys have been in this company for 6 years or more, almost from the beginning, which is again, you know, unheard of in the startup sort of ecosystem. And I think there is only one reason, maybe two, why this is happening in our company. So one is ownership, entrepreneurship at the core of it. Once a task is given to someone, open this city, open this market, open this kitchen, there is no micromanagement. Success is his, failure is his. So this, you know, building entrepreneur after entrepreneur after entrepreneur has really worked for us. And secondly, there is no boredom at Rebel, because today you're working on some food, tomorrow there is some other food. In fact, every Wednesday there's a food testing session. Now, if you leave Rebel, you are not part of the food testing session. So I guess that's a big reason why, you know, people tend to stick about.